General.
Codsworth.
May I accompany you, sir?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Work to do. Can't talk now.
Yeah.
Have you found someone that can help me become human?
Motion! Radiation!
I haven't found anyone yet.
Please, continue. Have you found someone that can help me become human?
Dr. Romari may be able to help.
Then we must see this. Something, monsieur.
I'd like to travel together some more.
Then let us get underway.
Ah, Miss Curie. Never was there a more suitable replacement.
So gracious of you, Monsieur Codsworth. Until we meet again.
What's that?
Can we see the old steakhouse? Maybe they have the tourist brochure.
Doctor, my friend here needs your help.
Oh? I'm not a mechanic. What could she possibly want from me?
Greetings, Doctor. I wish to download my data and co-programming into a human brain.
You want what? Is she serious?
Curie has a lot of pre-war research data, but she can't continue her important work as a robot.
Why not?
There are fundamental limitations in my robotic systems. I have no capacity for the human trait of inspiration.
I've never considered anything like your proposal. It's an interesting problem. The memories wouldn't be hard. We translate those from the brain to computers and back all the time here. It's how the loungers work. Her personality, though. All the extra pieces of robotic program decision-making. A normal organic brain wouldn't know what to do with them. A synth brain, on the other hand, well, it's already somewhere between the two.
Why would it only work on a synth?
To be clear, it may not work. But some synths have cybernetic enhancements that interface directly with their brains. The Institute must have found an interpreter for raw data. That's my hope, at least.
I don't have a synth brain handy, Doc.
I may be able to help with that. You know about the mind wipes I perform on synths. But the procedure isn't always successful. If something goes wrong, it can leave them in a brain-dead state. Living, but with no cognition. I know a caretaker for one of these brain-dead synths. If they're willing, we could try transferring your friend's consciousness into her.
So you're willing to perform the operation?
My patient knew the risks and opted for memory replacement. She wanted a new life. I failed her. But this procedure may be as close as I can get to fulfilling her wishes. But I cannot make this decision. Her caretaker can. Give me a day to get in contact with them. They're understandably cautious, but I think they'll hear me out.
I will stay with the doctor. Assuming all goes well, I want to be ready for the procedure.
Calling all Silver Shroud fans. I got an urgent mission. If you're a true fan, stop by the memory den and to talk to Kent Conley. The Silver Shroud needs you.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just a...
Got the memory pod loaded up? Oh, you're not Irma.
Hi.
Good neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just gotta escape a little to make it through the day.
Escape? What do you mean?
Reliving old memories. Like Thanksgiving, 2071. Mom made a 12-pound turkey. And then we all listened to the Silver Shroud versus Captain Cosmos. Even Pa was there. You ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
What can you tell me about the Shroud?
He's from the radio shows. I've listened to all 419 episodes. And the holiday special. He's the best. Better than Grognak and Man-to-Man combined.
My family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Wasn't he a caveman?
Yeah, that's the one. They found him in an iceberg off the harbor. Boy, if you just woke up. The world these days must take some getting used to.
How did you get used to everything?
Mainly I focused on survival. It got real bad after the bombs fell. For a long while, I tried not to think of the good old days. Just too painful. But it's all we got now. So we gotta try and make it better. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real? With his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life. So we can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun. Even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. The genuine Silver Shroud costume herself. And they actually got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
Do you really need the costume?
With the gun, I'm just another armed hooligan. But if the Silver Shroud came to life and helped people, it would give everyone hope.
I'll get the costume for you.
You're gonna do this? For real? Before the bombs fell, they were filming the Silver Shroud pilot over at Hubris Comics. So that's where you'll find it. You're the best.
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Hey, Irma.
Oh, enjoying yourself in Good Neighbor? It's a heck of a town, ain't it?
Got a dangerous look about you. Hope you ain't here for me.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Hey.
I'm all in. Cheers. That. Then. That's one way to get that coolant pumping.